Hi guys, Shir here. Second vlog. I'm going to Israel in 3 weeks. I'm going to be studying at Machon Tal. Most people aren't familiar with the school. It's part of JCT, the Jerusalem College of Technology. Oh, you don't know what that is either? Okay, so you know the Yeshiva Machon Lab? Well, it's the Machon Tal is like the sister school of Machon Lab. I applied to the nursing program at Machon Tal back in December, but they couldn't accept me until they had my SAT score. Of course, I didn't take the SATs back in high school. Like, why would I have? The only people who took the SATs in my high school were girls who were planning on going to Stern or Touro. And I wasn't one of those people. As far as I knew back then, my life was in Toronto. I was just going to stay in Toronto, and why should I go study extra hard for a test that I would never need? So, of course, by the time I found out that I needed SATs, it was too late for me to take them to apply for the January test date, so I had to wait all the way until May to take them. Because in Canada, we don't have the in-between date. There's, in America, they have another test date between January and May, like sometime in March, I think. But in Canada, we don't have that. So I had to wait all the way till May. It was very agonizing for me not to know what was happening that year, because for me, I'm the type of person, I need to know what's going on with my life. I need to know what the plan is. I wasn't really so worried about the SATs themselves, because the Machon Tal only cares about your math score, first of all. Second of all they want is a 520. And that's not very high. For those who aren't very well informed on SAT scoring, in a brief note, basically the average math score that people get is 500, and so since Machon Tal wanted a 520, it wasn't that much above the average. I'm an above average student, and especially coming, most people taking the SATs in high school, grade 11, grade 12, and I'm taking it after first year university, so I wasn't worried in the least bit. I finally took the SATs, and then 2 weeks later I had my score, which I quickly emailed to Machon Tal, and surprise of all surprises, I got in. It was really just a technicality why I wasn't accepted before then. School for first year students at Machon Tal starts in Elul in mid-August, and for everybody else, second year, third year, fourth year, in Cheshbon after the Chagim. But the courses that first years have to take in Elul are designed just to get them up to a university level in sciences. So you take courses like general chemistry, cell biology, a math course. But since I have already done a year at in university, I was exempt from the Elul courses. So I get to go to Israel later, which works for me, and I'm fine with staying in Toronto a little bit longer. But another problem is that I'm missing orientation, which I would have liked to be there for. Now I just get information on how to make my schedule, because now I'm going to have to do that from here. I get the key to my apartment to tour the buildings. So now I don't start school officially till October 10th, or sometime around then. But I'm arriving in Israel September 15th, a month early. That's just a few days after Rosh Hashanah. I wanted to be in Israel a while before school started, you know, to give myself time to get over jet lag, settle down. I also wanted to be there for Sukkot, seeing as now I'm going to start keeping one day of Yom Kippur. I'll be the first to admit it. The idea of fasting Yom Kippur in Israel, where it ends at 7, compared to fasting 8:30 here in Toronto, as kind of appealed to me a little bit more. Also, flights are a lot cheaper. It's crazy that how the prices of flights are so different from 1 week to the next. Flying between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur is, let's say, around $700, $750. I think my flight was $730. Compared to flying between Yom Kippur and Sukkot, like right before Sukkot, I guess people want to go in for Yantif, it could go up to like over $1,000. So I chose a good time to go. Plus, my cousin Israel's making bar mitzvah just before Sukkot, so I thought it'd be really nice if I had a chance to go. So that's it, and I guess I'll have another video next week. All right, bye.